One of Cush's son was Nimrod, the mighty hunter. Cush was Noah's third son, and the least significant of Noah's three sons. Nimrod sprung from a line cursed by Noah. Cursed be Canaan, a slave of slaves, shall he be unto his brethren. Nimrod is depicted as the first of the powerful men to emerge from the flood. Before we get fully into the video, if this is your first time here, make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon for more amazing videos from us. First and foremost, what does the name Nimrod imply? It is derived from the Hebrew term marad, which means rebellion. It becomes an infinitive construct, Nimrod, by adding a N before the M. The rebel then is the meaning. As a result, it's possible that Nimrod isn't the character's name at all. It's more than likely a disparaging name for a type, a representation of a system that is exemplified in defiance of the Creator, the one true God. As civilizations were reconstructed after the flood, rebellion sprang out. This figure rose to prominence during the period. Nimrod had no right to be the king or ruler by birth. He was, nevertheless, a tremendous, powerful guy, as well as a crafty and cunning hunter and trapper of men and animals. His adherents multiplied in number, and Nimrod rose to become the powerful ruler of Babylon, with an empire that spanned other large towns. In the country of Shinar, Nimrod founded a huge dominion that comprised Babel, Erech, Akkad, and Calneh. Later, he expanded his power into Assyria, constructing the towns of Nineveh, Rehoboth, Ur-Kala, and Rezin. Nimrod was clearly a capable and a visionary leader. Nimrod, as one might guess, did not feel safe on his throne. He was afraid that a descendant of Noah's heir and successor, Shem, might arrive one day and assume the kingdom. He was adamant about not being challenged. Some of Shem's ancestors had already been compelled to flee the area and establish their own towns and empires. In his nation, just one notable member of the Semitic family remained, Terah. Nahor's son was his name. Terah was the eighth generation in a direct line of Shem's descendants. Terah, Nimrod's most devoted and trusted servant, posed no threat to him. Terah had long since betrayed his family and become a Nimrod devotee. Astronomers observed a new star emerging in the east one night. It became lighter every night. Nimrod was informed. Nimrod gathered his astrologers and wizards. They all believed that this signified a new baby would be born, one who would pose a threat to Nimrod's reign. To avoid this, it was determined that all newborn baby boys would have to die, beginning with the king's own castle and ending with the smallest slave's hut. Nimrod stood on the top of his palace with his stargazers, and he witnessed the awed sky display firsthand. "What does all of this mean?" he inquired. "There is just one possible explanation. Terah, the king's father, has given birth to a son who would threaten the king's rule." Terah had never occurred to Nimrod that he would become a parent at the age of 70. If he became a parent, though, he would gladly give his firstborn son to his monarch and god. Nimrod immediately sent a message to Terah, instructing him to appear with his newborn son. Except for his wrath, not much is known about what he did and how he died. Nimrod is linked to the Tower of Babel as the ruler of the Kingdom of Babel. Nimrod claimed he would be revenged on God if he should have a mind to drown the earth again. For that, he would construct a tower too high for the floods to reach, according to historian Josephus, and that he would seek vengeance on God for the slaughter of their forefathers. Antiquities of the Jews, Book 1, Chapter 4. The purpose of the Tower of Babel, according to Josephus, was to preserve humankind from another flood. The first flood, however, was caused by humankind's sinfulness and disobedience, for which mankind refused to repent. There is evidence that both the Gilgamesh epic and the Hercules myth have their roots in Nimrod's life. Nimrod was clearly a powerful, charismatic ancient hero figure who sought to construct a tower to the heavens in order to defeat God's designs. It's easy to see why so many myths and stories arose in the aftermath of such a figure. Nimrod's strength and splendor, however, came to naught in the end, since God is greater than even the mightiest of mankind, and he cannot be stopped.